Time is 10 minutes after 6, and unfortunately for me, I went to the bathroom and I made the worst discovery for a Muslim fasting female. Like, why sit? Do you know the time is? Let me show you. I'm even stammering. I'm sure it's not showing. 10 minutes after 6. Why did this thing not wait until? Oh my God. I feel like crying. 10 minutes after 6. 10 minutes after 6. It's really, 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 really so annoying. In case you don't know, a female Muslim that's seeing her period is not supposed to fast and pray, because at that point she's shedding like blood and it's considered impurity. So you are not supposed to fast or pray, but you are going to pay back the fast you miss. That is, if your period is for 5 days, you are going to pay back those 5 days you missed during Ramadan. So it's really annoying, because most times you start your fast from the pre-dawn meal up until like evening, then the period now show face. As in, it's really so annoying. Sometimes I get lucky, or people get lucky, it comes after you break your fast or before you eat your pre-dawn meal, so you know that, okay, I'm not fasting. But the heartbreak is when you've taken up your fast and you've waited and it just comes. Like, just imagine, that was last year Ramadan 6, that's 2020. My period came 10 minutes after 6. Haba. It was really annoying, but it's not all that bad. So if you're a guy and you think this video is not for you, please stay put. This video is for everyone, for the females and for the guys. I will be sharing with you guys things you can engage in to gain a lot of reward, even as you are not fasting and praying. The only thing you don't even do is fast and pray. You can engage in every other thing. So I'll be sharing with you guys. And guys, please stay put so that you can share with your wives, your friends, your sisters. You always have a female around you, so any female around you might need this information. Welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, my name is Rukimo and we share nothing but positive vibes here. I talk about I show my lifestyle, opinions, and basically positive vibes. I'm in for positive vibes anytime, any day. So today, you already know what we are talking about. We are talking about menstruating women during Ramadan, menstruating Muslim women during Ramadan. If you have not subscribed to my channel yet, what are you waiting for? Is it until I come to your house and knock at your door and tell you, please subscribe? Because subscribe, Joe. If you have not subscribed, please subscribe and like and share and watch my previous videos. They are very educating, entertaining, and interesting. Thank you very much. How is your fasting going? How is it going? For me, it's tough, especially this period of Goma now we are. Okay, traditionally in where I come from, the fasting days, the 30 days of Ramadan is divided in three. That is traditionally. First 10, they call it Goma Namarmari. Goma Namarmari means the first 10 days of the fasting that comes, you know. When Marmari means when you are longing for something. So you know, we long for Ramadan, and when it comes, those first 10 days are easy because it's Ramadan. Then the middle 10 days is called Gomanawiya. Wia means difficult. So, you know, they are really difficult because you fasted 10 days and you are going to fast another 10 days. They are really tough. I don't know how it is, how it happens, but it's really tough. And it's the same hours, but it's kind of tough. Maybe exhaustion, I don't know. Then go Shirin Salah, that is the last 10 days. That one, Shirin Salah means in preparation for Salah. That is, so you are looking forward to Salah, you are buying new stuff, you are buying stuff for Salah. So during the last 10 days, the fasting is not difficult. But Islamically, that's not how it is. Islamically, it's divided. The first 10 is for blessings, Allah's blessings upon our lives. The second 10 is for forgiveness, and the last 10 is for emancipation from hellfire. And that's where we have the last 10 days of Laylatul Qadr. I'm not going to do a video about it, so try and intensify your worship during the period of Laylatul Qadr. It's like the best 10 nights in this world. I pray that God blesses us to find it, to seek it, and I pray that God makes this easy for us. Without wasting you guys' time, let's go. I'll be sharing with you guys nice tips that you can do even as you are on your period to keep your Ramadan going, to keep it fulfilling, to earn plenty rewards. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Verily, this is a matter that Allah has written for all female children of Adam." So, period is not a curse, it's a blessing, and it's a natural phenomenon you cannot help. So number one thing a Muslim fasting woman should do is she should read the Quran. Yes, you are not supposed to touch the Izul Sittin, that is the complete Quran. But these days, there are Qurans on our phones and there are Qurans that are in bits. So you can just take those ones that are in bits and read. So you can read the Quran, you can listen to the Quran, you can read the English version and know the meaning of these things you are reading. That's number one. Number two, you can engage in a lot of zikr. Zikr is praise and remembrance of Allah. And there are lots and lots of zikr you can engage in that would earn you big, big reward. So you can engage in lots of zikr at your free period. You just keep doing the zikr. Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wala ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar, subhanallah, ilazi wa bihamdi. You can hit me up for your zikr. Number three, send blessings upon the Prophet. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala Ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala Ali Ibrahim fil alamina innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammad wa ala Ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala Ali Ibrahim fil alamina innaka hamidun majid. Okay, I didn't even want to read it, but I started, so I needed to complete. I hope you read with me, you recited with me. So send a lot of blessings and salutations to our Prophet Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sorry about that sound. We shall continue this video because I am trying to maximize the little energy I have. Nothing is gonna stop me. So send a lot of number four, give a lot of charity. And in case you are looking for where to give charity, I am charity mistress, so give a lot of charity. We feed people for iftar every Wednesdays and Saturdays, and in the last 10 days of Ramadan we do it for the last 10 days. There's a borehole charity that is going on, and there's a masjid charity that is going on. You can hit me up for all your charity. Number five, make a lot of dua. Dua is prayers. Make like, God, I want, make a dua for yourself for this world and the year after. Ya Allah, I want a new car. I want you to take me for Hajj. I want you to do this. Ask a lot of dua. The month is a month that is filled with blessings, so you don't even need to like sit down and pray to before you make your dua. Just keep making your dua. Anytime it comes on into, anytime it comes to your head, you make this dua. Number six, repentance. This is a very beautiful time to seek repentance. Ask Allah to forgive you your sins, the known and the unknown sins. Astaghfirullah, Rabbighfirli. There are a lot of repentance
You know what I'm saying? Number 7, feed the fasting person. So the reward for feeding a fasting person is you get the same reward as that person that fasted, without your own fast being, without detracting from the person that fasted reward. I hope I made sense. Anyways, you get the same reward as the person that fasted when you feed a fasting person. Number 8, be kind to others, assist people, just show kindness here and there and you get your reward. Number 9, engage in a lot of righteous deeds. Attend tafsils, just engage in it, just be righteous, engage in a lot of righteous deeds. And that is the end. So this Ramadan, please make it count. Make every second count. If you can't make every second count, make every minute count. If you can't make every minute count, make every hour count. Don't allow an hour go by without you achieving something for Allah, without you achieving something for yourself that will benefit you in this world and the hereafter. I'm not a preacher. I'm just a good girl seeking akhirah. So don't look at me and be like, this person that is preaching. Anyways, make every minute, second, hour, day count. Don't go about wasting your day. Don't go about wasting the month of Ramadan. As I always say, this could be our last. So use it to the best you can. I wish us a happy iftar. Iftar Mabarak.